to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We've got it. This transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you want to go?
It's Alex Jones, coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this worldwide Sunday transmission. Events dictate that I be absolutely focused, cogent, and on target today, because undoubtedly we are entering a phase in human civilization that is one of the most dangerous, if not the most dangerous, we have ever faced as a society. We are going to be here for the next 2 hours, as we are every Sunday evening, 4 to 6 p.m. Central, and back, of course, tomorrow, Lord willing, 11 a.m. Central, 12 noon Eastern, for the three-hour weekday transmission. Okay, obviously on the radar today, QE Infinity, hyperinflation. Another big ratings agency now lowers. We were AAA, AA, now A-minus for the U.S. dollar. Federal Reserve running the republic into the ground, a foreign banking cartel that has captured this nation to a great extent. They don't have full control, but they've got control over monetary and over most of the federal government and the state government. So we've got that information coming up. And obviously, when you get ready for the big collapse, not this ongoing slide, what do globalists do? They start big wars. That's 101 of geopolitical imperial operations. We are now entering that with the whole situation in the Middle East going up in flames, the dead ambassador, the political hyping of all this, Obama's UN ambassador making utterly ridiculous statements today that this was not a coordinated attack on the embassy in Libya. That's like saying the sun didn't come up this morning. And all the political back and forth that's happening with that, all of it pales in significance, quite frankly, because we can handle financial degradation. We can handle Muslims burning down, you know, cities. What we cannot handle is a nuclear war with Russia or China. And many top generals, many top analysts are on record saying this could easily get out of hand and turn into a World War III scenario. The world's much more dangerous than it was at the height of the so-called Cold War. That's not just Alex Jones saying that. That's Zbigniew Brzezinski. That's people like Webster Tarpley. That's countless others. The magnitude of what we're facing. Now, you remember 2 months ago, and the videos and articles went viral, I said the preparations are being made for martial law in late October, early September. And you heard the police officers call in, break down crying and saying, yeah, we've been told, prepare for total breakdown, prepare to call in Air Force airstrikes on the American people, prepare to, you know, to totally cordon and round people up, military speaking out, army manuals publicly released for re-education camps. The government is running around like a chicken with their head cut off right out here at the Austin airport, former SAC base. They've leased areas all around it with the military. Every city is the same, every major key a strategic city. They're digging in more than they did at the height of the Cold War in the 50s, 60s, 70s, okay? They're running around like it's the end of the world. Now, I've said, hey, 2012, you know, I don't believe in the Mayan stuff. That's all a bunch of bull. But the globalists, they believe in stuff like that. They're a bunch of occultist lunatics. All I can tell you is my family's getting ready. This is real. And I've told my crew out there, this isn't a game. They know it's not a game. Let me tell you, this is the real deal, ladies and gentlemen. What our ancestors faced at the start of World War I and World War II, if this thing kicks off, will look like a walk in the park. And I'm talking to high-level generals, former top spies, you name it, they're scared. They're scared. Okay, this is serious. We're going to be back in 60 seconds. I'm going to lay it all out. Stay with us. Alex Jones here with a very important announcement for Truth Seekers. We've carried a lot of amazing films and books over the years on the online video bookstore at InfoWars.com. And out of all the titles we've carried, one stands out because it is just so chillingly convincing. And that's Dreams from My Real Father by Joel Gilbert, available at InfoWars.com. This film exposes the fraud that Obama is like nothing I've seen. If you want to know who Obama's real daddy is, this is the film for you. Don't forget, your purchase supports our broadcast and our growing media network. You'll also find at InfoWarsShop.com, None Dare Call a Conspiracy by Gary Allen, the book that woke me up. We're also carrying Behind the Green Mask, UN Agenda 21, by Rosa Corey. This book is coffin nails to the globalist takeover. The Greater Good, the most professional and up-to-date film I've ever seen, exposing the scourge that is vaccines. These titles and a lot more are all available at InfoWarsShop.com.
You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. From deep in the heart of FEMA Region 6, Austin, Texas, transmitting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
I feel like saying a prayer at the beginning of this broadcast, something I've never done. I don't know how I get people to pay attention. I mean, really pay attention to just how much danger this world is in right now. Just how hardcore this corporate banking world government is and just how sinister they are. They are playing civilizations, nations, groups off against each other. And that is the important thing to know and understand. Again, thank you for joining us on this 16th day of September 2012. I am your host, Alex Jones. I have, of course, the syndicated broadcast carried by XM on 166 weekdays from 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern on over 115 AM and FM affiliates. And then we also come back Sundays for the Sunday transmission, 4 to 6 p.m. Central, 5 to 7 Eastern, 2 to 4 Pacific, 3 to 5 Mountain. We are broadcasting worldwide on global shortwave, WWCR, and, of course, on several satellite systems, as well as the audio streams at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Okay, you know about the Middle East going up in flames. You know about U.S. troops getting killed all over the Middle East and Africa and Central Asia, Afghanistan, Pakistan. You know about the embassy being attacked in Benghazi and the U.S. ambassador being killed. You know about the announcement by the private Federal Reserve of quantitative easing unlimited, or quantitative easing infinity. Obviously, most of you know about the massive domestic arms buildup by the federal government against the American people, the 1.4 billion bullets the last year, the giant armored vehicles by the hundreds ordered every few months, the mobile armored pillboxes, the staging of military supplies, including treaded tanks in every major U.S. city by the thousands spread out across the United States. This is a buildup for World War III, but not the type of war our daddies or granddaddies fought. This is a globalist, banker-directed war against the nation states so they can have us basically battle it out, all controlled and run by the very same global banking system. They brag about this, by the way. They write books about it. They put out policy papers. It's not hidden. They just think you're so stupid and only watch, you know, the television news programs and that you'll never even understand it. That's their arrogance, and that may be their undoing. Let's hope. Now, we do have Dr. Steve Pachinik, who is the person who helped co-write many of Tom Clancy's books. He is the person that the character of Mr. Ryan is based on from Patriot Games. And I'm not going to get into his whole bio, but he's overthrown governments, run assassination squads all over the world, and is a psychiatrist, and among other things. And we have him on occasionally, as you know. He'd been talking to me the last few days quite a bit. And what shocked me is I called up Webster Tarpley, Dr. Tarpley, who's also lives there in D.C. and has his ear to the ground. And the two men basically told me pretty much the same thing, which was what I had also basically from the research understood. So they're going to be joining us. Coming up in about 20 minutes, Dr. Pechenik's going to join us. And then we're going to have Dr. Tarpley on after that to give us his perspective on all this. But you're not going to get just talking points here and mindlessness. So if you're a new listener and you want to really know what's going on in the world, you're going to get it here, okay? As close as you're going to get to it. Not because I'm that smart. The mainline system lies to you on purpose, okay? It's not hard to actually know what's going on if you study this stuff from a historical perspective and actually follow the continuum of developments and read the memoirs of globalists and spies and foreign memoirs and research. Let me just boil it down to you very, very simply. There are six global banks that are above the law that have created 1,500 trillion plus in global derivatives just based in the dollar. Fraudulent counterfeit money. They've sold it to the Russians, the Chinese, the Americans, to your police pension fund, to the school pension fund, to the private pension funds, everything. It infects everything by design. They have gotten all the governments with their operatives that they've worked for decades to get into place, signing us onto their debt, and the media tells us that it's our debt, when over 90% of it is not even national debt or personal debt. It's their debt. It's fake derivatives. It's a black hole of fraud. But when they get you up to the point of bankrupting the world and bringing in a global depression, they have to be in the position of posing as the saviors during the global reorganization, like the Marshall Plan after Europe was wrecked. And it's actually the same corporation that's at the top of it, the OECD. They have to be able to reorganize everything after they collapse it. And to do that, they have to have a big war going on because they know now that you know the Federal Reserve is private and part of a foreign European banking cartel. They know now that you're starting to wake up, as Brzezinski just wrote in his book that came out this year, and that the elite are in trouble. So they've always run Al-Qaeda. They created them. They've always run them. I told you they put them in Libya. They put them in Syria. They put them in Africa. And I told you they put AFRICOM in Africa and then have their operatives. Al-Qaeda works for these banks. And our troops are trained and ordered to train them and give them weapons. That's all on record, hiding in plain view. And they dump them out to murder Christians, other Muslims, you name it, destroy infrastructure. So the globalists can then come in and carpet bomb the country, thinking you're so stupid you won't remember that just a year and a half ago they put them in charge in Libya. That's when the whole thing started. And 8 months ago started this new war against Assad in Syria. By the way, Dr. Pechenik was actually arrested by Assad's father. I mean, that's how much globetrotting he's done. But we'll get his take on this whole situation when he comes up here in about 15 minutes. The point is that they are gearing up for a giant war with Iran and beyond, not just as an October surprise to control the election or Carterize Obama. At the top, it's the same power group. Sure, they've got political arms that fight with each other. And for the mid-level operatives who think they're at the top, they think there's different camps. But at the very top, they've got a focused group pushing this that wants to cause giant regional wars bordering on third world war or major world war to re-engineer global society and bring in a total police state that's already in place, but they want to fully roll it out. Face scanning to buy and sell, total control, checkpoints at the end of your street. This has all been geared up. You're the target. Remember I told you 10 years ago, Al-Qaeda works for the globalists. They're going to get you to give up your rights in the name of fighting Al-Qaeda. Then they're going to tell you that domestic groups are the new terrorists. Now they've said gun owners, libertarians, returning veterans, constitutionalists, the old-fashioned family who aren't the new normal, we are the bad guys. That's in all the law enforcement manuals, Homeland Security, the police have sent us, that's made national news. You've seen that in the news. You know that. This is all for you. This is a global banking cartel getting nations to get into fights with each other so that everybody goes into deeper debt and so we politically don't understand how we've been economically conquered. Now notice, we said that these big wars would start with civil unrest and with Al-Qaeda they put in all these countries. When the global acceleration of dollar devaluation and other currency devaluation, because they're all pegged to the dollar, whenever that started. And it's been gradual, but now it's reached an acceleration point. So there's no doubt, ladies and gentlemen, and not just my intellectual acumen, my spidey sense, my sixth sense, I know yours as well, has gone past the point of getting chills over this. Now I'm locked in. Well, I just got one right there. Locked in, focused, it's game time, okay? Get ready, ladies and gentlemen. Unless we get the word out about what's really happening, we're probably going to have World War III and a global depression that'll make the Great Depression look like a piece of cake. We'll be right back.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat it any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct. Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
For thousands of years, silver has been used as both a medicine and a preservative. But not all silver is equal. Silversol is an amazing new technology that has been clinically shown to be several hundred times more effective than colloid or ionic silvers. It can destroy thousands of times more pathogens than older silver technology. Silversol resonates at the same frequency as germicidal light used in labs to kill bacteria and viruses, enabling it to kill without direct contact. Silversol is a broad-spectrum microbial that creates no resistance and does not harm beneficial bacteria, making it ideal for daily use. It can be used internally as well as topically and is highly effective against viruses, bacteria, molds, and yeasts. With threats like West Nile virus, colds, flus, or any other emergency situation, arm yourself with supernatural silver. Silversol liquid and gel are perfect for on-the-go emergency preparedness and can provide protection at home, school, or work. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and be prepared for any emergency. Remember the promo code Alex Says for 20% off. That's www.supernaturalsilver.com and like us on Facebook.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We now take you live
to the Central Texas Command Center
in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to the Alex Jones Show.
There are times in history when you see governments lining up on different sides of the battle line. And that's happening right now. Because the global banking cartel has created a Ponzi scheme that if they don't get governments to sign on to, they're all going to go to jail. Now, they tell us, hey, sign on to the Ponzi scheme or everything will collapse. But mathematically, by many orders of power, it's impossible to ever get out of a collapse if, this is very, very important, if we don't decouple ourselves from the derivatives fraud. These people have taken the world over through this fraud. And the globalists are absolutely opportunistic. They don't serve anything but raw power. What do I serve? I have people ask me that all the time. Major media executives, generals, famous spies. Like, who are you really working for? You know, there's nobody out there who doesn't work for somebody. Really? I don't like bullies. I don't like losing my liberty. I don't like losing my freedom. I don't like being a slave. I don't like seeing my republic destroyed. I'm upset by gangs of lesser men getting together and taking over government and sucking off of me. I really do believe in a level playing field. I really do believe in free association. That's not old-fashioned. That's not being a romantic. We're in this situation because we stopped being romantics who stood up for ideas of real freedom. We got lazy and stupid. Now we've got a bunch of kleptocratic elites getting ready to bring us into a major war. There's a reason there hadn't been a world war since World War II. It's called hydrogen bombs. It's called bioweapons. But the globalists have all gotten into eugenics and kind of hyped themselves up that, oh, well, we'll use the national security state to get total power out of this coming crisis. No, you're going to end up destroying our civilization. And I'm sick of you. I listen to talk radio as people try to understand what's happening. We told you they put Al-Qaeda in Libya and Syria and all over Africa and Sudan. We told you, ladies and gentlemen, our troops are in Afghanistan to grow 93% of world opium. It was less than 10% before the liberation 10 years ago. We told you they're running Al-Qaeda. And now it's been in the LA Times, the New York Times, and the CFR saying we need Al-Qaeda. And Al-Qaeda are good guys. And then Al-Qaeda starts killing U.S. troops all over the world and goes and attacks an embassy and was able to get through. And then Al-Qaeda brags, we know your security procedures. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Pechenik is going to come on the show. Dr. Pechenik, when he was on months ago, said he confronted Admiral Mullen at the Council on Foreign Relations. Turns out later that came out in the news. And Mullen came out and said, don't blame the U.S. when Israel hits Iran. What do you think all this is about? Pechenik says it was Israel and elements of the Pentagon that hit that facility. You just think Al-Qaeda, who they put in Libya and Syria and in Pakistan, just did this on their own? They work for the globalist, period. And you've got Obama out there running around telling everybody that, oh, everything's fine now. And, oh, no, it wasn't coordinated. It wasn't organized. This is an October surprise to Carterize Obama. But it's bigger than Romney. Understand that. This is very sophisticated because there's people within the Obama administration that are involved at this just as much as people in the Republican power structure. Because at the top of the pyramid, it's the same people. That's even what most of their high-level operatives don't understand about this system. They're planning what PNAC wrote, what Dick Cheney wrote back in September 20th of 2000 in Rebuilding America's Defenses. Look it up. It's public. That they would cause a clash of civilizations by funding and radicalizing Muslims and then letting them attack. Meanwhile, the police aren't training to fight radicalized Muslims, folks. They're training to take your guns and take you to re-education camp because you're a red-blooded American. You're the target. And I hear these people dripping with salivating enjoyment on talk radio about Obama blew it. It's over for him. Yeah, the Al-Qaeda, you know, Obama tried to say they were our friends, but look, he's getting it. This was the policy under Brzezinski. This was the policy under Carter, the policy under Reagan, the policy under Bush 41, on and on and on. It's the policy under George W., under Obama. They're puppets. The whole world is a stage. Each of us players upon it. Well, not me. Not me, man. I'm not playing part in your World War III stage. We're in that same PNAC document, Rebuilding America's Defenses, we just showed on screen if you're watching us at PrisonPlanet.tv. If you're a radio listener watching us online, the TV side of this, you can go read it where they go on to say we need to legitimize the use of bioweapons to wipe out certain races. We need the media to legitimize that use. These are mad men. And they say we're mad because we don't want to engage in things like that. They also say they're history's actors and that what we say and do doesn't matter. They'll decide reality and change what reality is day to day. The only people starting to change reality are the ruling class who've lost touch with it. Just like Nero and Caligula and Hitler and so many others, you guys are smoking your own dope. You guys are drinking your own Kool-Aid. You people are crazy. You always bite off more than you can chew because you BS people so much, you start losing touch with what's reality. You destroy the Bill of Rights and Constitution. You create a surveillance state pointed at the people because you want to secure the country you took over as the heart of your global empire, your homeland. The pit you dig for us is the one you're going to fall into. You get rid of due process. You get rid of separations of powers. You allow the nastiest people in the system to go to the fore. That's why there's always a race to the bottom once evil is allowed in. So I'm going to state it for you very, very simply here and succinctly, okay? The Federal Reserve said we'll never do quantitative easing 3. That would cause hyperinflation. Instead, they've announced unlimited quantitative easing, but not just to the people. The people don't get any of this money. It all goes to mega offshore banks to buy their bad derivatives. And then the media tells you you're in debt because it's your debt, when almost none of it is your debt, because you don't have economic understanding. The average political know-it-all is like Miss Teen USA who couldn't even talk. We're going to play a clip of her later. You think that woman's a moron? You're a moron when you try geopolitical analysis because you're not taught a real system on the news. They give you one-dimensional or two-dimensional at most systems. When this thing is three-dimensional chess on so many other levels. It's like playing 100 games of chess at the same time, okay? You only can have a historical understanding to be able to even war game this because humans act the same over and over again. That's the only way to understand this. Here's the deal. Here's the news. Al-Qaeda in Yemen urges Muslims to kill U.S. diplomats over film. The film has nothing to do with it. It's just the excuse. Military Afghan inside attacks kill 4 U.S. troops. Sudan rejects U.S. request to send Marines to guard embassies. NATO copter destroyed by Taliban at Bagram Air Base. Americans killed in Libya was on intel mission to track weapons. What, the 10,000 missiles that Al-Qaeda got, that our government gave them? Armada of British naval power massing in the Gulf as Israel prepares to strike Iran, London Telegraph. Notice all this is happening. They're devaluing the currency globally. It's the world reserve currency, the dollar. That causes people in third world countries to start starving to death, accelerating the rioting, and the globalists want to ride this storm, order out of chaos.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct. Alex Jones here with a great way to beat the blackouts, get off the grid, and generate your own supply of electrical power. Folks, with what's been going on in this country, I don't have to tell you about the power grid and just how vulnerable it is. That's in the mainstream news every day. Millions of people have lost their power in the last few weeks because of dangerous storms and killer heat that's pushing the grid beyond its capacity. I've always said that every family needs to be ready for blackouts. And if you don't have a backup system in place, I've got a great opportunity for you. Right now, our good friends at Solutions from Science are offering huge savings on their best-selling Power Hub unit. In fact, I think it's the best deal I've ever seen them make. It's literally thousands of dollars in savings. Remember, these backup systems don't need gas because they're solar-powered. That means there's no dangerous fumes and no noise. InfoWars listeners can get all the details at beattheblackouts.com. That's beattheblackouts.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic. It's Alex Jones.
All right, we've only got him a little bit into the next hour, so I'm going to try to give him the floor, but have him get right into it in a language that all of us can easily understand. Dr. Steve Pachinik, MD, PhD, is an American psychiatrist, former State Department official, author, publisher. He co-wrote a lot of Tom Clancy's books, had a lot of his books turned into big films. He's a critically acclaimed author and psychopolitical thrillers and the co-creator of the best-selling Tom Clancy Op Center and Tom Clancy's Net Force paperbacks. Trained in psychiatry at Harvard University, international relations at MIT. His novels are based on over 20 years. Yeah, he was a colonel in Black Ops, wrote the book on psychological warfare for the State Department, then adopted by the CIA, helped overthrow governments, assassinations. He won't get into it, but you can look him up if you'd like to. Very serious person we've got on the line. Member of the Council on Foreign Relations. He told me on air when he was on about a month and a half ago. The interviews are there. They're posted at InfoWars.com. Just look up the last interview. He said, yeah, I just confronted Dempsey. Got in his face and said, that's the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. And then it came out in the news later, actually, that Dempsey had been confronted. They didn't say it was Pachinik at a Council on Foreign Relations meeting. And then Dempsey came out and said, hey, the U.S. won't be behind the Iran attack. We don't want the blame. Well, it doesn't matter. We're going to be sucked into it. So just amazing inside info. He's not supposed to talk about what goes on inside the meetings of the Council on Foreign Relations, but we've only got him for, again, three segments. We're going to get him back on later in the week because they're gearing up for a giant Iran strike, huge carrier task force groups, British build up, 20 nations plus have their 25 nations are converging on the Strait of Hormuz. You've got the killing of the U.S. ambassador in Benghazi. I've talked to a lot of my sources, and they all say, including Pechenik, October's surprise basically to Carterize Obama. And by the way, Pechenik worked for Carter, George Bush Sr., and others. So he's bipartisan in his, quote, service to the country. But here to break this down for us, the point we're at geopolitically right now is Dr. Steve Pechenik. StevePechenik.com is his website if you want to find out about his best-selling books. Good to have you here with us, Doc. I'm going to try to shut up and give you the floor because we don't have a lot of time, but please break down where we are right now. I mean, I know you were against Obama, exposed the bin Laden thing, so it's not like you're for him to expose that this is meant to be blamed on him, this killing, but clearly the media is trying to deep-six Obama. What's behind this geopolitically?
What's behind this geopolitically is the extension of what you were brave enough and your audience was brave enough to understand. This is all an extension of the 9/11 disinformation and false flag episode. It continued into the issue of the CIA and the confrontation between the CIA and our military and the President of the United States continuing on the covert activities and trying to reposition themselves in the Middle East while the military under General Petraeus and under other generals are trying to pull us out of the Middle East. What's happening now is we have the overview of a Shiite power, the Iranians fighting the Sunnis, which is Saudi Arabia, but in the middle is Israel continuously playing with all of the players, including Saudi Arabia, and particularly the diaspora Jews and the Jews of the United States, as a way of putting pressure on Obama, as a way of pushing pressure on General Dempsey and General Petraeus to say that we want red lines in order to be able to attack Iran, and the answer is repeatedly, even by General Dempsey, the answer is no. We will not give you a red line. General Petraeus said not only we will not give you a red line, but we want you to know that under no circumstances, and I do not talk to General Petraeus, I'm a great admirer of his, I know what he is doing, is that he has repeatedly stated, as I had, that from a geopolitical point of view, Israel is a strategic liability and has been a strategic liability for over 20 years. Since 1968, we have had no need for Israel other than the fact that it covered us under the Soviet Union on the eastern, southern, and northern flank. For the first time since 1948, geopolitically, Israel is confronted by Hezbollah, a proxy for Iran, by Hamas and the proxies on the eastern bank of Jordan, and on the south by the Islamic Brotherhood or Al-Qaeda, all of which they were part and parcel of. Israel is not innocent of any activities. And contrary to Bibi Netanyahu's speech today to CNN, where he wished everybody a Happy New Year, I in return wish Bibi Netanyahu and the Israelis a Happy New Year and wish that he first begin to tell the truth, that the involvement of Israel was in 9/11. Over 134 Mossad operatives were picked up in 9/11. The FBI picked them up, debriefed them. They were clearly involved with the Pakistani ISI and Saudi Arabian intelligence. Then we get to the old issue of Osama bin Laden, which Obama said incorrectly and lied to the public that Osama bin Laden was killed by SEAL Team 6. Admiral McRaven had lied repeatedly. Unfortunately, this is an admiral, a decent admiral, but for whatever reason, he repeatedly insisted on saying SEAL Team 6 killed Osama bin Laden when, in fact, on your radio show 10 years ago, I said he was already dead. The Navy SEAL Team 6 will be disciplined by General Petraeus and others in the special forces. So what this means, in effect, is that we had an ambassador who was a very honorable ambassador working in the State Department under very good Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, who's been doing an excellent job of keeping everything quiet, as alongside of a lot of diplomats, including Mark Grossman and others, and a president who's tried to maintain this war and contained it in a very effective way. and may have been undermined by the following people who once again came out of 9/11, your friends and mine, the neocons. Chicken hawks, Paul Wolfowitz, once again hiding behind Mitt Romney, Elliot Abrams, hiding behind Mitt Romney, Chertoff, the head of Homeland Security, who now heads off the Chertoff Group, which is nothing more than a cover for the CIA and FBI, run by Charles Allen, a former CIA operative, all hiding behind Mitt Romney, who himself has no idea of what he's talking about in foreign policy. So you have a president, a presidential candidate, who can't utter even the right words, with an entire team composed of Bob Zelig, Roger Ailes, and Murdoch. He has no idea that the most important enemy, he says, is Russia. No, Russia is not our most important enemy. We are a superpower. As Colin Powell has said repeatedly, cool it, Mitt Romney, and get your facts straight. Mitt Romney is being run by a guy named Don Fencer, a protege of the neocon vultures, Paul Wolfowitz, Richard Pearl. And once again, what we have is a fight between the neocon Jews, Israel on their side, and the fact that we have an intelligence service that is split under General Petraeus, trying to maintain peace and stability in the Middle East, a State Department that's trying to maintain peace and stability, and a situation that has been provoked through agitation propaganda through local Libyans and as well as foreigners meeting mercenaries and others concerned with agitation propaganda in order to destabilize Libya and to particularly assassinate our ambassador. Why this particular ambassador? I think it's very important for your audience to understand who Christopher Stevens was. He was considered, and the key word here is in Arabic. It's a very rare word to use in the description of an outstanding foreign service officer. An Arabic was a term that was used by the neocon, the Israelis, and others who did not like experts who were specially trained in Arabic studies, spoke Arabic, were sensitive to the Arab culture, were trained specifically in what was considered the Protestant college developed in the 1800s by famous missionaries on our part. This was all Presbyterian missionaries, which eventually became the the Beirut University of Lebanon, where subsequently great men like Mr. Kerr and others were trained in. An Arabist whom I had worked with on the only peace treaty that has ever existed was part of Christopher Stevens.
All right, we'll stay there. And basically, Doc, we got to go to break. Come back and explain it in layman's terms here. I know you're talking to the intelligence community, but I mean, obviously, you're not a fan of Obama either. But you told me, you're saying Israeli intelligence with Saudi intel is who killed the ambassador. This is pretty big news. Stay there.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds could become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com. Or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat it any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
For thousands of years, silver has been used as both a medicine and a preservative. But not all silver is equal. Silversol is an amazing new technology that has been clinically shown to be several hundred times more effective than colloid or ionic silvers. It can destroy thousands of times more pathogens than older silver technology. Silversol resonates at the same frequency as germicidal light used in labs to kill bacteria and viruses, enabling it to kill without direct contact. Silversol is a broad-spectrum microbial that creates no resistance and does not harm beneficial bacteria, making it ideal for daily use. It can be used internally as well as topically and is highly effective against viruses, bacteria, molds, and yeasts. With threats like West Nile virus, colds, flus, or any other emergency situation, arm yourself with supernatural silver. Silversol liquid and gel are perfect for on-the-go emergency preparedness and can provide protection at home, school, or work. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and be prepared for any emergency. Remember the promo code Alex Says for 20% off. That's www.supernaturalsilver.com and like us on Facebook.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We are on the march. The Empire is on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
That's right, an empire of corrupt criminals that work together who want to destroy liberty and freedom worldwide. It's real simple. You're for freedom or you're for tyranny. I stand with liberty. Now, Dr. Pechenik won't brag about himself, but over the years interviewing him now for about 11 years or 10 years, I've looked him up, and you come across him. He was the main psychiatrist or psych warfare guy that Jimmy Carter had in the Camp David Accords with Anwar Sadat and actually got him to do the deal. By actually really talking to him. So he knows what he's talking about here. So what they're saying is this ambassador, well, I mean, it's simple. You want to get a war going, you kill the ambassador, you get your jihadis that are in there to start blowing stuff up, and then you blame Obama for it. Now, let's be clear. I don't like Obama. I don't like Mitt Romney. And I really don't like Obama on his anti-gun, all the rest of it. I mean, Dr. Pechenik's worked for George Bush Sr. and Brent Scowcroft. So he's not political as well. He's just giving you what he believes is really going on. I mean, do you really believe anybody that a bunch of jihadis went through all those special forces guys they had guarding the ambassador? Do you really think there were only four security guards there? I mean, Al-Qaeda, quote, bragged that we know your security. So this is amazing. So just tell me what you told me privately in that 45-minute conversation we had yesterday, Dr. Pechenik. I mean, tell people where we're standing right now. I mean, how this ties into Iran, where this is going.
What we are is at the brink of war that's being precipitated by two major countries. That is Israel, particularly Bibi Netanyahu, who knows his country is failing economically, socially, politically. He is isolated by the United States. When General Petraeus 2 years ago said correctly, it's a liability. He already immediately tried to take action to draw us back in by mobilizing the Jewish committees like AIPAC, the Zionists, the neocons, and Mitt Romney, and all the men behind them.
But by the way, you're Jewish, Dr. Pechenik. You're Jewish, so you're not...
I'm Jewish.
Yeah.
I come out of the Holocaust. But remember, Netanyahu did not come out of the Holocaust. Contrary to everything Netanyahu is telling America and is telling Obama, everything he says is a lie, including what his father wrote. His father was a teacher at Cornell. What he continuously says, and I'm saying this as a Jew on the eve of a holiday, is that the Israel was the foundation of salvation for the persecution of Jews. Nothing could have been a greater lie than the fact that Israel or Palestine at the time was of no value to the Israelis, on the contrary to the Jews. On the contrary, when Eichmann came and he was trained in Hebrew, 1927, a deal offered by Hitler to save thousands of Hungarian troops and Jews in return for trucks, Ben-Gurion said, I would rather have 400 cows than one diaspora Jew. Repeatedly, Israel turned down any help to help the diaspora Jew. They did, however, in 1933 in Palestine, take 36,000 German Jews in return for money and worked with Heydrich who was a Jew. I'm talking as a diaspora Jew. There were 165,000 German Jews called Mischlinger in Hitler's army. None of which Netanyahu wants to talk about.
Dr. Pechenik, this is super deep history you're getting into, and we appreciate you.
Let me just say something. Everything Bibi is saying to America and to the American Jews is an absolute unmitigated lie. Not since 1968 was Israel ever interested in the diaspora Jew or using the Holocaust. Then they created a machinery to use the Holocaust as a way of mobilizing guilt and anxiety over the world. But they're not the only culprit. The next culprit is Saudi Arabia and the Sumari Seven. That is the wife of King Abd al-Aziz. Let's put it this way, very simply. The Faisal and Saud families are not legitimate heirs to Saudi Arabia. It was created by England. They created, in a concept called divide and conquer, a family that came out of Diriyah. Most of you saw that in the Lawrence of Arabia film. It does not exist. They are Wahhabis. They distort the Quran. The message of the Quran throughout history has always been peace and love and working with all of the religions. They were formidable, and the Wahhabis are the total distortion. The true descendants of Mecca and Medina are not the King Faisal of Saudi. They are the Hashemites. But the British took them away from Saudi Arabia, put one in Iraq who was 4 years old and another one in Jordan so that they would never have an ability to have the true leaders of Prophet of Muhammad. So what we have here is a collusion between Saudi Arabia and the neocon Jews of America and Israel against a president who, whether I like or dislike, and may have lied on Osama bin Laden, is the son and it's the son of a CIA operative, the grandson of a CIA operative who understands very well what the issues of intelligence are, including the United States ambassador, who understands very well what
happened. Sure, put it in layman's terms, though, for people. Sure. Bottom line, what's the point of killing the ambassador? What's the point of turning out?
Killing the ambassador is to precipitate a war so that Israel can finally get into Iran and try to destroy Iran. It will be the beginning of the end of Israel. It's Armageddon for Israel. Israel wants to go in, but it wants to force America to take it out of its trouble in Iran, because Israel cannot succeed in any flight into Iran. It is impossible logistically and strategically. Israel lost every war since 68. There is not one war they have succeeded in, despite what they may say to everybody else. And the last war, where they lost thousands of men, will be a reminder to the Israeli mothers that every time they send their children to war, they will die in multiples, and no Americans will come to help you. Petraeus will not come. Dempsey will not come. Neither will any other soldiers or intelligence operatives. So what we have here is an internal strife against Saudi Arabia, the United States, attacking one of our ambassadors and killing them in the name of the fact that he was a representative of the United States, and he was an Arabist. Now, let me tell you what an Arabist is very quickly so your audience understands. They were famous people who helped to develop a, a treaty. The only treaty that's ever been done between Israel and a Muslim club in Egypt was called the Camp David Accord, of which I was privileged to be a member. And one of the most famous people there was Herman Iles, the ambassador to Egypt, an Arabist. Another one's Frank Wisner, who should have been Secretary of State, a great Foreign Service officer. Another person is a man by the name of Chas Freeman, who was accused by the neocon of being pro-Israel, anti-Israel, because he speaks Arabic. He's a scholar. He's a Foreign Service officer. Well, so what you're seeing here is a division within the United States by Zionists, not Jews only, but Zionists, Israeli Mossad operatives, and Saudi financing in order to denigrate the value of our Foreign Service officers who are trained in culture, Arabic studies, including April Glaspie. And the president who got rid of all of our Arabists under neocon pressure was Clinton. Ironically, Hillary Clinton was trying to maintain the peace. Her husband was totally intimidated by the neocon Jews to get rid of every Arabist in the State Department and put in people like Martin Indyk. Indyk, who was ambassador to Israel, was nothing more than an Australia spy who within one day became an American citizen, was appointed by Dennis Ross, another neocon who works with Paul Wolfowitz, and made our ambassador to Israel.
All right, well, let me stop you. Doc, we're going to have you back up very early this week for an hour and a half because obviously you need to go over this whole history for people that don't understand it. But here's the issue. We're about to go to break, but what I need you to understand here is you've got the British fleet massing. They never go somewhere unless there's a war. You got 25 nations all gathering. This is hardly in the news. You've got QE Unlimited starting. You've got our government digging in like it's the end of the world. All the evidence I see says they're going ahead in October, late October with this, and it could lead to World War III. Is that accurate?
That is accurate. It could be earlier than October because we have Yom Kippur, and I predicted on your radio show, and I predicted to our national security people privately that Bibi Netanyahu would start something on Rosh Hashanah. This was over a year ago, and I said it on your radio show. He was as predictable as a clock, and the Israelis will be very predictable on Yom Kippur in a couple of weeks. They will try to initiate another war unless their ex-Mossad operatives and their ex-Shin Bet will take out Netanyahu and do to Netanyahu what happened to Rabin. They know what I'm talking about. Otherwise, he will bring down Israel, the world, and there will be a third world war. Turkey is trying to help us. Russia is trying to help us. Syria.
Well, Dr. Pechenik, I think everybody knows what you were talking about right there. I'm in over my head. This is pretty hardcore stuff. All I know is I want peace. I don't want a world war. And I see the police, everybody digging in for what they say is the end of America, and I don't like it. I don't like where this is going because a bunch of people want the end of the world. People in Israel, people in Iran, and a bunch of Christians who I don't think are very Christian. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Second hour coming up. This is Real Radio. Alex Jones here with a very important announcement for truth seekers. We've carried a lot of amazing films and books over the years on the online video bookstore at Infowars.com. And out of all the titles we've carried, one stands out because it is just so chillingly convincing. And that's Dreams from My Real Father by Joel Gilbert, available at Infowars.com. This film exposes the fraud that Obama is like nothing I've seen. If you want to know who Obama's real daddy is, this is the film for you. Don't forget, your purchase supports our broadcast and our growing media network. You'll also find at InfoWarsShop.com, None Dare Call a Conspiracy by Gary Allen, the book that woke me up. We're also carrying Behind the Green Mask, UN Agenda 21, by Rosa Corey. This book is coffin nails to the globalist takeover. The Greater Good, the most professional and up-to-date film I've ever seen, exposing the scourge that is vaccines. These titles and a lot more are all available at InfoWarsShop.com. Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require
require electricity, purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back live, ladies and gentlemen. I am just absolutely stunned right now by the things that Dr. Pechenik is talking about. Clearly, the way the mainstream media is absolutely pouncing on and going after Obama is just so clear. I don't like Obama. I hate him. I hate his socialism, his anti-gun, all of it. I wish Romney was an alternative. I'm not saying vote for either one of them. And I know Pechenik is you know, apolitical when it comes to this. Doc, we only got about 5 minutes left. You've really dropped some bombshells here, but most analysts say this could easily lead to World War III. And the neocons are trying to destabilize Russia and overthrow them, trying to turn them into a new enemy, a new arms race. Doesn't the military-industrial complex know if they start World War III, there won't be anywhere to spend all that money they're getting?
Well, the military-industrial complex at this point is totally denuded. What they're afraid of is the $2 trillion the decrease in money that they're going to get in the military. But the military right now is divided. What you have is military generals who've had experience and no longer want to go into Iraq and Afghanistan and have told the president and others, this is enough. We have to get out of the sandbox, as General Petraeus says. And we have to leave. We have a bigger issue that's much more important than Middle East for us, and that's cyber war, as Keith Alexander said, and it's just the issue, as Obama said, East Asia and the Pacific and China's growing influence.
The United States has lost all of its soft power by going in there, among other things, to, quote, help Israel. And notice these invasions haven't helped Israel. Israel is more insecure than ever.
That's correct. Because of their own paranoia and continuous paranoia and the insecurity, they keep feeding it in a loop. And what happens is their soldiers are no longer equipped. Remember, these are not the same Zionists that came in and established the State of Israel in 1948, which, by the way, they then committed in 1948 euthanasia and genocide, which subsequently the Israelis admitted to.
The ringworm children. The ringworm
children. Killing the Palestinians.
Well, they also killed a bunch of the Sephardic Jews with the radiation. You know about that?
Yes, I also know that they created a lot of agitation and propaganda in Morocco in order to force the Moroccan Jews to leave a very friendly friend to the Jews, King Hassan of Morocco. So the Israelis and the Zionists have created used the Jews of the diaspora, that means the Polish, Russian Jews, and Sephardic Jews, as a weapon to manipulate world opinion, to create agitation propaganda, in the same way Saudi Arabia is using their people, the Salafists, to be the thugmen against the United States and use it in the term of Al-Qaeda or any form they want. But Saudi Arabia, which is falling apart now because it's only a second and third generation illegitimate ruling class from an illegitimate king, is now in the process of falling apart. Both states, Israel and Saudi Arabia, are in desperate situation, and they're trying to force America back into the Middle East.
Well, you got Dempsey.
Obama correctly is saying no. And while Petraeus is saying no, Dempsey is saying we will not go to war in order to protect you.
Well, Doc, in closing, we're going to get you back up in the next few days, and we appreciate your time, stevepechenik.com.
My pleasure, and thank you.
But I mean, in closing, you did confront Dempsey. You told us about it. Later, he came out after that and said, hey, don't blame the U.S. or me of Israel attacks. I think the answer, short of what you were talking about, which I certainly don't want earlier, is to have our military and our government unify and say, we're not going to do this. Stop it. Because if they don't call this out, if this looks like false flag city to me, because if elements in Israel are this arrogant right now, they might pull a false flag. What do you say in 20 seconds?
They absolutely pulled a false flag. This is a false flag. Our military clearly pointed out to me that the Libyan embassy was very far away when they had 2 days' notice, and basically,
I'll tell you what, do two more minutes. We've got our next guest coming up, but do 2 more minutes, 1 minute break. Come back and make the point about embassy security. Dr. Pechenik's our guest.
Alex Jones here with a great way to beat the blackouts, get off the grid, and generate your own supply of electrical power. Folks, with what's been going on in this country, I don't have to tell you about the power grid and just how vulnerable it is. That's in the mainstream news every day. Millions of people have lost their power in the last few weeks because of dangerous storms and killer heat that's pushing the grid beyond its capacity. I've always said that every family needs to be ready for blackouts. And if you don't have a backup system in place, I've got a great opportunity for you. Right now, our good friends at Solutions from Science are offering huge savings on their best-selling Power Hub unit. In fact, I think it's the best deal I've ever seen them make. It's literally thousands of dollars in savings. Remember, these backup systems don't need gas because they're solar-powered. That means there's no dangerous fumes and no noise. InfoWars listeners can get all the details at beattheblackouts.com. That's beattheblackouts.com.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Well, he's been a top hostage negotiator for the State Department. He wrote their book on psychological warfare. He's overthrown governments. BBC and Telegraph say he manipulated the communist who he's fighting against to kill the prime minister of Italy. He'll never talk about that on air every time we bring it up. He served, I don't know, 4 or 5 presidents. He was a colonel before that from the Vietnam era in Black Ops. Only got a few minutes left with Dr. Steve Pechenik, who is Jack Ryan character. Clancy said that's a composite of Dr. Pechenik and a few others, but that he helped write those books. He's one of the experts helping Tom Clancy, and he's also, again, had his books put into major films. He's a very accomplished person. He's a big deal, and he's here telling us this, and he's communicating with intelligence agencies all over the world right now through this show. And you could take away from this what you want. I don't think you're idiots. So I will bring on high-powered guests who will have discussions like go on behind the scenes at the Pentagon, the high-level brass meetings, and the highest levels of the Council on Foreign Relations. This guy's worked for George Bush Sr., worked right under Henry Kissinger. I'm not going to get into it all, but I mean, he's definitely from the major power structure. And the fact that he's here saying these types of things, he's been on the show off and on for 10 years, really is frightening because he's not pulling any punches now. I mean, Dr. Pechenik knows where the bodies are buried. Doc, you're going to be back with us Tuesday for an hour and a half because this is moving quickly. World War III, right. Financial collapse. That's why all this is happening. But talk about the embassy and the killing of the ambassador in Benghazi and the point you've made that your average jihadis, you know, basically couldn't do this and the message that was sent and how that ties into your sources. You were telling me off air that your Pentagon sources, I mean, they know who really killed this guy and the message it's meant to send.
Well, the message he was meant to send, the Pentagon sources had informed me that the distance between the Libyan embassy where our ambassador was and where the rioters were was so large, and 2 days of a delay in response, meaning simply that they were professionals ready to take out our ambassador, who was an Arabist. And the reason I say he's an Arabist, he was basically, they wanted to kill him because he was too influential in the Arab world. He was too dangerous to Israeli interests, to Saudi interests, and to certain American national security interests run by the neocon. Now, when we say that Obama's like Carter, I worked for Jimmy Carter, and Jimmy Carter was the only president of the United States to ever make a Camp David peace accord, the only president of the United States to implement the human rights issues, and the only president of the United States to fire 4,000, listen to me very carefully, 4,000 human operatives of the CIA. He realized how disastrous the CIA had been, and what General Eisenhower had said all along, that this is a legacy of ashes, and it will destroy our country until we contain and restrain the CIA. And this is where Jimmy Carter, a great president in retrospect, and I think Obama should be very proud of him, but the neocons have degraded him to say this is our Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter was the only president who ever made a peace treaty with Israel. I worked with Anwar Sadat. I went with Menachem Begin. I worked with Herman Niles.
You got arrested by Assad.
Gas Freeman.
I mean, you got arrested.
These are the great men.
Well, you know, someday you've got to come on and talk about all the amazing things you did. I mean, I know most of it's classified, but you know
it's not. I'll talk about it, but let's have some more time, and I want to talk to your audience and thank them for listening, and thank you.
Well, let me ask you this question briefly here, Dr. Pechenik.
Sure.
What is the strategy? Because I know you were on here a few months ago criticizing Obama. I mean, I'm apolitical. I'm not Romney or Obama. I want to get your perspective. I respect your view and perspective. We're going to get another one here in a moment. I want listeners to really, you know, hear this inside info for themselves and decide if they think it's accurate or not. But how do they think they're going to get away with this? Putting Al-Qaeda...
Well, they're going to get away with it because, as I told you on the last show, there's a real issue that Dempsey had presented to the whole group of us, that we are the military, and our American military is really concerned about, and that is the few minutes delay time, a pre-positioning time that Israel will not give the United States, and it will launch an attack, which presumably by Netanyahu and the Israeli Defense Forces strategy will force us into saving them from total destruction. And the answer is Netanyahu has no idea that Petraeus will not save him, Dempsey will not save him, our Navy will not save him, McCraven will not save him, neither will Obama. He cannot get that message through. So he's pushing this through until he kills one of our ambassadors, precipitates what we call agitation propaganda, only with the approval of Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia and Israel are twins, they're doppelgangers. There's no way you can separate Israel from Saudi Arabia or Saudi Arabia of Israel. They go back all the way to 9/11. They go back to the days when Jimmy Carter fired 4,000 operatives because the people went to Saudi Arabia. Those people who were left in the agency went to Saudi Arabia, the Mossad, and the Pakistani ISI to reconstitute an intelligence service which was totally illegal. And many of those who came in the Carter administration, Jews, like Dennis Ross, Martin Indyk, who was an operative underneath the Australian government and was an American citizen for only one day, was appointed an American ambassador to Israel so Dennis Ross, a neocon, could control him.
All right, well, let me stop right there. Let me stop right there, Doc. We're going to be back on Tuesday to break this down. But bottom line, the 25 fleets, this is London Telegraph, Associated Press, are converging. 25 nations are converging on the strategically important Strait of Hormuz. They've never done this in the last 5 years of saber rattling. My intel is right now Israel has tentatively greenlit an attack anytime in the next month and a half against Iran. Iran will then attack U.S. bases all over the Middle East with their missiles, drawing the United States in by having the Al-Qaeda groups that Saudi Arabia runs start attacking U.S. facilities. They believe that will create a sympathetic response domestically in the U.S. for a call to attack Arabs because people are politically and geopolitically totally ignorant, you know, to the level of basically being brain dead. And so now there's this saber rattling, yeah, let's bomb the Arabs. You can see the manipulation. The propaganda is what targeted about a five-year-old mentality. Briefly, do you concur with that analysis?
Yes. Basically, I'll summarize it in this. As Hitler created the first Holocaust of the Jews, Netanyahu will be responsible for the second Holocaust of the Jews in the 21st century. He will be the Hitler of the 21st century to the Jews. On this New Year's Eve, this is what I say about Netanyahu. He was part of 9/11. He was part of the conspiracy, the agitation propaganda, the killings, and now the agitation and precipitation of war. When that war goes, we will have a Holocaust and a pogrom, the likes of which we haven't seen since the days of Hitler.
Okay.
This is our new Hitler.
Okay, wow. Dr. Pechenik, thank you so much. We'll talk to you Tuesday.
My pleasure. Bye.
All right, there he goes. We have Dr. Webster Griffin Tarpley waiting, and I did not even know this would go in this direction. I am in way over my head, and I study this stuff 24/7. Folks, if you knew who Dr. Pechenik was, I mean, he's been in every black op you can imagine. He's the guy Jack Ryan's based on in Patriot Games. I mean, Webster Tarpley is a doctor of history, an economist who's been all over the world, been to Tripoli under bombardment, just been to Syria. Pechenik's been arrested by Assad's dad before, back when he was the leader. I mean, it's so wild. I don't even know what to say about this. Pechenik is pulling no punches. I mean, I had no idea that would even go in that direction. And you know, as for Netanyahu being Hitler, again, I don't have a dog in this fight. I just want my Bill of Rights and Constitution. I don't want World War III. And, you know, you've got two famous Jews like Netanyahu, and you got Pechenik, who's Jewish, over there in this fight going on. It's above my pay grade, I'll tell you right now. We're going to break. Webster Tarpley for the rest of the hour, who I highly respect on this issue. Geopolitically, there's two people I respect more. In fact, he's incredible in his historical understanding and analysis, and I'm somebody that's somewhat learned. We'll just leave it at that. And we're going to come back with him. I am just absolutely flabbergasted right now, and I'm speechless. But you're going to see a lot of wild stuff happen, folks, because the dollar is going into hyperinflation. They're gearing up for martial law in the U.S. That's now publicly admitted. 1.4 billion bullets for us. The Russians are lining up for war. The Western interests are trying to overthrow Russia, stirring them up. There's fleets off the coast of China menacing them. Japan's being agitated into conflict with China. And you've got just all of this craziness taking place. This is the stuff you see before world wars. We'll be back.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct. Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure. And it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139. Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers. The prognosis for the entire planetary economic system runs from bad to worse. The globalist model is to shut down societies and starve patriots out until they acquiesce to the global takeover. That's why we've assembled the most vital and important preparedness items at InfoWarsShop.com. These are items that I did research on, that I personally use. You've got the Life Straw, so you can turn fetid water into safe water anywhere you go. The K-Tor hand crank generator to charge up key equipment during power outages or out in the field. Strategic Relocation, 3rd edition by Joel Skousen. When Disaster Strikes by Matthew Stein. Therosafe, used by Homeland Security to protect yourself during any radiological event. Hand crank shortwave AM/FM radios. Everything that we've researched and found to be the best is available at InfoWarsShop.com, and your purchase makes our InfoWar possible. We're getting prepared. Are you? InfoWarsShop.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center and the heart of the resistance, rallying patriots worldwide. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
All right, folks. Armada, a British naval power massing in the Gulf as Israel prepares an Iran strike. An armada of U.S. and British naval powers is massing in the Persian Gulf in the belief that Israel is considering a preemptive strike against Iran's covert nuclear weapons program. Now, you've heard all my police sources, FBI, defense intelligence, you name it. I told you 2 months ago, late October, early November, even police departments, and you've heard the cops call in mass when I say, here, just listen to police. They're being told in the intelligence units, get ready for total, absolute collapse, airstrikes called in on U.S. cities, martial law, lockdown in October, late October, early November. That doesn't mean this is going to happen. But the 1.4 billion bullets that have been purchased that the media spun into 174,000 for the Department of Health and Human Services or Social Security. That's how they strawman that when it finally broke and became a big story. Hundreds of millions more being purchased. Paul Watson's got an article coming out tomorrow at InfoWars.com on that. I'm a guy that wants freedom. And to defeat the globalists and the global corporatists that are anti-liberty, I've had to study reality. And I have really found a lot of how things tick. And I'm here to tell you, folks, that what you hear on the news, and you see all the Sunday news shows that normally worship Obama, turning on him today and grilling the UN ambassador for the U.S., they are trying to do an October surprise to Carterize Obama. That's the article from Webster Tarpley up at InfoWars.com. That doesn't mean I like Obama. I would love for Mitt Romney to be a good guy. The point is, you can't sit here and just go, oh, well, Obama's an idiot. Look, he put al-Qaeda in Libya and Syria. Webster Tarpley went there and decried this policy. It's a ship of criminals. Okay? I mean, Hillary, Obama, scum. The point is that the facts are the facts. All the lines lead back to the neocons and what happened to this ambassador. Webster Tarpley, break down in layman's terms where the world is today, the precipice we're at, and if you disagree that we're on the verge of what could be a World War III or financial collapse with QE Unlimited, and then get into what's happened with the ambassador, the rioting, the jihadis that they admit our government runs. Because if Obama put all the al-Qaeda in, why now are they turning against him? I mean, this is very complex. It's making my head spin. Webster, Dr. Tarpley, go ahead.
Why don't we just proceed methodically, and we can start with the attempted coup d'etat inside the United States, and then we can see what the ramifications might be in terms of October. The first thing to understand is, the agency that's making the Middle East blow up is the Romney campaign. The Romney campaign in the broadest sense. And of course, the Romney campaign doesn't just mean, you know, this little clique of people in Boston. It means the entire complex of forces that want Romney in and Obama out. Now, in order to understand this, we've got to start with this CIA Mormon mafia. It's a faction in the CIA. It's a faction in the FBI. It's known the Mormons send the young men overseas for 2 years to be missionaries. They learn foreign languages. They come back. They go right into the CIA. And they had a protector in high places. For many years, this entire establishment was dominated by Henry Kissinger. But Henry Kissinger had a right-hand man, and that's Brent Scowcroft. And Brent Scowcroft was a top Mormon. So using this policy that they have of promoting their own people, Mutual Admiration Society, it's kind of like the neocons, the upper reaches of the U.S. National Security bureaucracy are full of Mormons, and they realize that they want Romney because that will allow them to complete their careers at the highest possible level and have more power than they could have any other way. So CIA Mormon Mafia. Now, merged with that, as I've tried to point out, are the neocons. The neocons that were with Bush Cheney, some of them are more or less in the shadows. We got a whole new group of neocons. John Bolton is probably the one element of continuity, but we've got Dan Senior, we've got Robert Joseph, we've got Robert Kagan. We got a lot of these people, right? It's a whole different clique of neocons that want to get these posts. I call your attention to John Bolton, right? The guy with the mustache, looks kind of like a walrus. You've seen him on TV.
The guy who has very interesting admitted divorce papers.
I don't know about that, but he's the big hater of the United Nations, right? He's built his career as being UN ambassador and saying that he hated it. He couldn't get confirmed by the Senate, couldn't get confirmed by the U.S. Senate to be UN ambassador. All right, so this is one group. Now, separate from this, but allied, is, of course, Netanyahu and the Likud. And what we've had in this past week is this huge intervention by Netanyahu into U.S. politics in favor of Romney. Remember, Romney and Netanyahu are joined at the hip. They have been closest buddies since 1976 at the Boston Consulting Group when they sat together in the same cubicle. It's been an alliance all these years. BB gives Mitt advice about politics. Mitt gives BB advice about finance and how to design sanctions and so forth. And you saw Netanyahu coming out saying, "You cannot give us a red light because you don't have a red line." So the United States is supposed to commit to war under some future eventuality. That would be unconstitutional, right? Because, you know, we do have this question to the Congress, right? So Netanyahu also, he doesn't have a red line. He has never said under what circumstances he would strike. So Netanyahu wants the U.S. to be more Israeli than the Israelis, to be all the way out in front on this crazy idea of attacking Iran. We also had the deputy head of the Israeli Knesset on Morning Joe on MSNBC.
Well, I'll tell you what, let me just stop you. I want to tell all the good old boys.
Calling for immediate war. Calling for immediate
Webster.
War. You got to let me finish the
No, I will, but I just want to add for all the good old boys that want to, you know, start a war and think it's fun. I hope they enjoy $10 a gallon gas if the Strait of Hormuz gets closed. Go ahead.
Yeah, and of course it's the sky's the limit with this stuff. So we've got the Mormon Mafia. We've got the neocons having joined the Romney campaign. You've also got to figure that the Saudis are in on this. I think the Saudis would rather have Obama out, Romney in. The importance of them is that they're the paymasters of these terrorist groups, right? The Al-Qaeda groups, the Wahhabite.
They're the handlers.
The Salafis. They're the handlers, but they're also the guys who pay, right? Along with Qatar and with the United Arab Emirates and the rest of these reactionary monarchies in the Gulf. So what did they do? There are a number of sides to this thing. It's a multi-pronged faction converging on this, and they've got intersecting operations. Maybe we should start with this film. Now, the film is not the cause, but the film is the public relations cover. It's a kind of atmospheric that allows people to think they understand what's going on. So this is now the film, The Desert Warriors, and then it became The Innocence of Bin Laden. And then it became The Innocence of Muslims. And it's 15 or so minutes of garbage, right? It's scurrilous.
Stay there. We're going to come right back, Webster. And we've got a break, hard break here for news. When we come back, we'll look at this. By the way, Webster Tarpley wrote the unauthorized biography on Obama. To be clear, he doesn't like Obama. This is not a political hack up here. See, our love of the truth, our love of what's really going on, that comes first. You're not going to hear this anywhere else, which is kind of scary. This is really amazing stuff we're watching happen. We'll be back.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional-class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We now take you live
to the Central Texas Command Center
in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to the Alex Jones Show.
Well, Webster Griffin Tarpley joins us. He's written, what is it, 3 books on Obama and the criminals that run him. And now here he is on air, 2 on Obama. And now here he is, you know, telling us that, well, forces behind Mitt Romney that want a big war and a new arms race, basically, that they are the ones behind all this unrest. Well, then Obama sure fell into their trap, because Obama is the one, the Peace Prize winner, that bombed Libya and is now using Al-Qaeda to attack Syria. And Webster's been to both countries under bombardment. Webster has had a lot of courage to do that. So it really shows you that once you get into all this cloak and dagger stuff, basically the ruling class here is so reckless and so amoral that they're biting themselves in the you-know-what. I mean, it really comes to a point where Hitler turns east towards Russia, Napoleon does it, other empires go to Afghanistan to die. It shows a hubris, a contempt. Webster, I know you want to walk through the continuum of all this. We have your article, October Surprise to Carterize, explain that, Obama. Again, October Surprise to Carterize Obama, up at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com right now, along with all the other insane news. But you can see the embassy's getting attacked, the American flag's getting burned, and this cover of, oh, it's this film, even though this started before that even got hyped up. Clearly, this is being orchestrated to try to do just like 1980, where the Muslims respected Mitt Romney. When he gets in, they'll stand down. And again, the whole thing staged. I'm not supporting Obama either. I know that you haven't been an Obama supporter. The point is, this could lead to World War III, as every mainline analyst is saying. Even the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Dempsey, who's been pro-war in the past, came out and said, if Israel attacks, we're not involved and we're not helping. That's a serious message. So now this is a way to prod the U.S. into action. At least that's what it seems like. So you've laid out some of the pieces here. Tell us what the game plan is from all your sources there in D.C., where you live there, next to D.C. in Maryland, and where you see this going and what the larger strategy is to strike Iran. Is it purely political, or is Israel really worried about nuclear weapons?
The essence of the strategy right now is to put Romney in the White House, and then Netanyahu gets everything he wants, with war or without war. A lot of the war talk right now is a hype to try to get people to stampede in the direction of Romney. But let me just go back. This film, okay, the film that we started to talk about, the key guy in the group of people around that film is this guy Nasrallah, the Coptic Christian. And he leads you directly into the so-called Islamophobia network. It leads to a group of people that includes Pamela Geller. It's an organization called Stop Islamization of America Now. There's one called Stop the Islamization of Europe Now. There's Stop the Islamization of All Nations Now. It's an international network. They've got that guy Geert Wilders from Holland, Islamophobic race baiter. But you go from Nasrallah to this Islamophobia network, and who do you find in the middle of the Islamophobia network? John Bolton, top neocon, and likely Secretary of State in a Romney administration.
Sure, so, all this goes without saying, Webster, that it's a cartoon. It's just like the Muhammad cartoons put out by the neocons, and the media covers it, so the Muslims burn down half of Europe, so they have a pretext to then invade more.
Four. Bolton spoke on WMAL Radio here in Washington this week. Here's Politico. And he says, I come back to Tehran in 1979. If we're not careful here, we're going to see a repetition of that crisis, which was, of course, a major factor in contributing to the destruction of the Jimmy Carter administration. So it's clear what they want to do. They've been managing Obama on a Carter plan up to now, right? The trilaterals, the Bilderbergs, all these people, Wall Street. And now they want to get him out. And in order to get him out, what do you need? Well, what got Carter out? A hostage crisis and an October surprise. In the case of the October surprise, it was to prevent Carter from freeing the hostages, right? The famous negotiations of George H.W. Bush, Bush the Elder, talking to the mullahs in Iran, telling them, don't free any hostages, deal with us later on. I think they learned to regret this. So there is no doubt that the film is essentially a production of the Romney campaign. Now let's go to the death of the ambassador, right? This Arabist ambassador, new Arabic, new French. This is J. Christopher Stevens. Why would he be killed? Well, first of all, you get many signals of an inside job, right? He was, according to the things I've seen, he was not at the actual consulate. He was over at a safe house nearby, which should not have been known to the people attacking the consulate, whatever that was. but it was known. And they began attacking with mortars, right? People have talked about the professional, coordinated, high-level quality of the attack on the safe house, which eventually killed Ambassador Stevens. Who killed him? Well, the indications coming out of Libya is, of course, it was planned, and it was carried out by an organization called Ansar al-Sharia. And the head of that is a guy called Kumu, Kumu. So this guy, Kumu, is a graduate of the Guantanamo Bay Training School, because that's what's going on in Guantanamo now. Guantanamo, one of the reasons Obama couldn't close it, it's used for training. Because they let these people out after they've been carefully prepared to do what they want to do. There was this guy, Shiri, was let out. He created Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. He's now, I think, been killed a couple of weeks
ago. No, it's a training camp under the cover.
A training camp. So Kumu is a CIA asset. And Kumu then goes and kills the U.S. ambassador. Now, that's where I'd say, call the Mormon mafia and ask them what's going on with that. Right? Why is a CIA asset killing a U.S. ambassador, right? Why did they?
Do you agree with Pechenik, Dr. Pechenik, that it was Israel, Likudniks with Saudi Arabian intelligence? Because
I'm telling you, it's the CIA Mormon mafia. Let's get right to the heart of the matter. Without the CIA ran that guy. He was trained in Guantanamo to do what the CIA wanted. Always beware these people who are telling you, blame somebody else. Blame somebody.
Got it. All right, but let's talk about. Hold on, Webster. Let's talk about then Obama. Why is he having the ambassador go out on TV and say, "Oh, this wasn't coordinated. It was a few protesters." And Obama called people, and everything's fine now. Why is Obama playing in to the lie then?
Well, Obama, of course, is a feckless puppet, right? Obama's a Wall Street puppet. I think Obama has figured out by now that his former patrons and masters have decided to dump him. That's what makes this moment so interesting. It's a little bit like Harry Truman in 1948, right? The reactionary Wall Street people wanted to dump him, but somehow he was able to stay on. So I think people have to go.
All right, give us big picture. Where is it all headed? I mean, the intel we're getting is
it's headed towards a seizure of power by Romney and the neocons. Now, what does that mean? It means another reversal of the field, right? Remember, we had Bush, Cheney, neocons, war in all directions, bomb them, invade them, rivers of blood for the U.S., tremendous expenditures. And then we had Obama, and Obama says, no, I do it all with color revolutions. I do it all cheaply. He has drones. He has special forces. He did have the one bombing.
That's the Pentagon model. That's why the Pentagon likes Obama.
Divine plan. It's a CIA plan. CIA. It's a guy called Divine. So it's not the divine plan in the sense of God, but it's Devine. And this is what they're carrying out. Now, the neocons.
Which is Brzezinski.
The neocons say that's not good enough. We want to start, smashing more people. And they also say the Russians and the Chinese continue to defy us. We just had 30 countries meeting in Tehran as friends of Syria. We just had 130, 140 countries meeting in Tehran. They're saying their strategy isn't working. So the idea would be to reverse the field and go back to a warlike, aggressive foreign policy. And for that, they would like Romney and the neocons and Secretary of State John Bolton, who's got his fingers in this movie somehow.
Yes, absolutely. Now, let's talk about where all this goes, though, with the Iran strike. I mean, they don't have the police running around digging in for World War III for nothing. They're not buying 1.4 billion bullets for Homeland Security to play tiddlywinks.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require
require electricity, purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
For thousands of years, silver has been used as both a medicine and a preservative. But not all silver is equal. Silversol is an amazing new technology that has been clinically shown to be several hundred times more effective than colloid or ionic silvers. It can destroy thousands of times more pathogens than older silver technology. Silversol resonates at the same frequency as germicidal light used in labs to kill bacteria and viruses, enabling it to kill without direct contact. Silversol is a broad-spectrum microbial that creates no resistance and does not harm beneficial bacteria, making it ideal for daily use. It can be used internally as well as topically and is highly effective against viruses, bacteria, molds, and yeasts. With threats like West Nile virus, colds, flus, or any other emergency situation, arm yourself with supernatural silver. Silversol liquid and gel are perfect for on-the-go emergency preparedness and can provide protection at home, school, or work. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and be prepared for any emergency. Remember the promo code Alex Says for 20% off. That's www.supernaturalsilver.com and like us on Facebook.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
All right, here's the deal. I'm going to be live on the radio 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central tomorrow at noon Central, 1 p.m. Eastern. So 1 p.m. Eastern, 12 noon Central. We're going to have Webster Tarpley on for a full hour tomorrow, maybe even a second hour, and take phone calls because we're trying to get down into real issues here. Not hey, there's some brown people over there, and they're burning our flag, so let's attack Iran. When it's the Wahhabists out of Saudi Arabia that are Sunni, that the globalists control, that they're using to do all this. And our media says Iran's behind Al-Qaeda. I'm not a fan of the mullahs. I don't want to live under that type of, you know, control. I'm not for Iran. I'm for freedom. I'm for not having World War III. And they think you're so stupid, folks, they tell you Iran is Al-Qaeda. I mean, the Sunnis and Shiites hate each other more than there's any strife between Christians and Muslims. But the system plays on your inherent ignorance. Now, here's the deal. The government is digging in. Government is preparing. I've interviewed police off record and on record, as you've heard her on the air. But my sources all over the country, including police chiefs, have been told late October, all hell is going to break loose. They said, just get ready. It's going to be like nothing you've ever seen. They've got the fleets massing like never before. I talked to one of my sources earlier this week out of a West Texas town. I'll just leave it at that, where the B-1 bombers were based, which are good weapons, but they also break a lot, so they never use them unless they're about to have a war. They've been sent to the Middle East, and I called my other source. They said, yeah, the B-2 bombers, the B-1 bombers, they're all over there now. Everything is mashed, okay? So they're getting ready. With the backdrop is the world financial meltdown and the banks looting everybody. Webster, we got about 10 minutes left. You got the floor to take us out. Pull back. Give us the big picture here. Where is all this going? How serious is the Iran strike threat? What should we expect if there is that strike?
Well, just remember, the Iran strike would be best conducted from the point of view of the ruling class by Romney with the neocon administration. Now, there is the problem of Obama right now that they'd like to get rid of. One of the problems in their way is that the Romney campaign is so stupid, so bungling, and so inept. They could have come out of this week with a big advantage, and I'm not sure they've come out with any. The hope that they have is that they'll make up for it in coming weeks. When this stuff began to happen, when you had the demonstration at the U.S. Embassy in Cairo, Egypt, and then you had the killing of a consular official, as they heard it, in Benghazi, Libya, in the terror corridor, right? The Benghazi, Derna, Tobruk terror corridor. That's when Romney decided to shoot his mouth off, right? He had said, oh, 9/11, I won't say anything. I'll have an embargo. But he couldn't restrain himself, because Romney had written a book called No Apologies. And obviously the neocons had ghostwritten the book for him, right? It's the Republican talking point that Obama apologizes all the time. It's not really clear that that's true. But this was something. Romney was Pavlovian dog, trained to react to this. So as soon as somebody said, we regret, or, you know, we don't believe in this, Romney seized on that and said, all right, you're apologizing. So he had to put out this very badly timed press release, right? And there is a question with Romney, even with the ruling class on his side, can he get himself elected, right? Because he's such a bungler. Now,
or let me add this point. I've got to ask this. We'll talk about it more tomorrow. Could the Obama controlling faction of the globalist, could they go ahead and launch the war or authorize Israel to as their own October surprise? I see it more of two camps fighting over who gets to launch the war and be the hero.
There is this question, right? There is the complication of the rally round effect. In other words, the neocons, I think, they've shown their political stupidity repeatedly in practice. And Netanyahu, in terms of international politics, has shown how stupid he is. But the point is, if you have a big international crisis, most Americans will rally around the president, whoever that is. And you can see that even under Carter, right? Carter, when you had the Desert One, right, the failed attempt to rescue the hostages in the spring of 1980, Carter got a bounce out of that helped him win the Democratic primaries against Teddy Kennedy. So they're playing with something which is a problem for them. But I think underneath it, it's not so much the election that they're worried about right now, although they want to win the election for Romney. It's how could you get Obama to endorse an attack? You have to stampede him. And the idea with that is the big danger of the Israeli attack on Iran or maybe somebody attacking Syria, right? Maybe some European country, NATO country, right? Maybe France, something like this, attacking Syria. This could then be used to browbeat Obama and get him to do things that I don't think he wants to do, not because he's a patriot, but because of his very narrow interest in staying in power and not screwing up his relations with his own base. So if you're going to have an attack and you want to stampede Obama, you got to do that in the last week, 10 days, 2 weeks maybe, before the election, so that you can tell Obama, if you don't join in this attack, you'll be denounced as a traitor.
I agree. And the reason I raise this analysis is that's what I see happening here the minute it started. It's two-way, and I agree. It's CIA or a faction that's neocon connected in the final equation that did do this with command and control and handling by the Saudis, as you said. So in a way, you do agree with Pechenik, but correct me if I'm wrong. The issue here is that they've got to stampede the kind of Chicago mafia Clintonista arm into politically not being able to deal with burning American flags, embassies attacked, U.S. troops killed, ambassador killed. And so the CIA is in control of that al-Qaeda network they use to take over Libya and now part of Syria. And so they're in control. They're like, hey, Obama, we just had this network attack some of your holdings. We're going to blame you now for not responding. So it is clear who's running this channel. The question is it going well for those factions? Will they now double down and intensify the destabilization program?
Well, as I say, the ineptitude and bungling of Romney is right now a factor in world history in its own right. That his obvious play this past week was to shut up, don't say anything, and let Obama take the heat for what's happening, right? Because everybody would then turn around and blame Obama. But Romney had to get himself in the middle of it, and half the Republicans then turned against him. But again, these are not the main things. I think the idea is to create hysteria. Now, you're talking about these police chiefs and others being told that something big is going to happen. Consider this. In recent world history, we have the so-called pre-Munich plot, right, that Chamberlain wanted to appease Hitler. He wanted to give Hitler everything he wanted. And in the various series of meetings that we think of as the Munich process, right, the Munich sellout, there were three meetings at least.
Got a minute and a half left.
In the middle of all this, Chamberlain creates this hysteria, right? Chamberlain wants to sell out to Hitler. So he has start digging trenches in the park, give everybody a gas mask, convince them that war is at hand, and then they'll support whatever you do. Now, it could be that this intelligence agency faction, and again, I stress—
No, I agree with you. They're always telling people that this is coming. It's just I've never seen this level of chatter, plus B-1 bombers, B-2 bombers, 25 nations fleets massing while the dollar begins to implode. I mean, Webster, so you're saying you're not worried about an Iran strike?
Oh, I'm worried. I'm worried about a Syria strike, perhaps even more. I think the Syria strike would have to be the prelude to the Iran strike.
Sure.
I think that's the one that's more on the
front. Got to take it out first. And you were just in Syria recently. We're going to talk about this tomorrow, Webster. Amazing. I have to say I agree with your analysis from all of my research. This is a very dangerous time because I think the ruling class is even fighting with each other. And, it's good to have separation of powers. But, man, this is crazy. What is the time?
Of course, you've got this ongoing financial collapse in the background, right? You've got— You always have to figure that the biggest danger at any point in the year is this September October period, right? The transition from the third quarter to the fourth quarter because of all the traditional payment deadlines and everything together with that. So we've got Spain on the brink, right? These Spanish states, right? Catalonia, Andalusia, going bankrupt. Draghi saying that he's going to provide support for the bonds, but only if you agree to the IMF conditionalities.
Yeah,
and now we've got this, the QE3. The QE3 would have been a help to Obama, but I think it's coming too late for Obama. So I still think that the ruling class is in favor of Romney, not Obama. And that becomes a very important—
Well, sure, it shows how petty they are that as soon as Romney attacked Bernanke and said he would get rid of him, Bernanke then did the QE Unlimited. We're going to talk about it tomorrow, Webster, in depth. We'll start tomorrow on the financial situation. 11 a.m. Central tomorrow, Infowars.com, PrismaPlanet.tv, Tarpley.net's your website. Thank you so much, Webster. And thank you to all the listeners for listening and taking action. Good job, crew.
Alex Jones here with a great way to beat the blackouts, get off the grid, and generate your own supply of electrical power. Folks, with what's been going on in this country, I don't have to tell you about the power grid and just how vulnerable it is. That's in the mainstream news every day. Millions of people have lost their power in the last few weeks because of dangerous storms and killer heat that's pushing the grid beyond its capacity. I've always said that every family needs to be ready for blackouts. And if you don't have a backup system in place, I've got a great opportunity for you. Right now, our good friends at Solutions from Science
are offering huge savings on their best-selling Power Hub unit. In fact, I think it's the best deal I've ever seen them make. It's literally thousands of dollars in savings. Remember, these backup systems don't need gas because they're solar powered. That means there's no dangerous fumes and no noise. InfoWars listeners can get all the details at beattheblackouts.com. That's beattheblackouts.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We've got it.